shows how to add some glam to your guest bathroom is Orly, and this is pretty fantastic. And I'll say this, it's not the first time that you've shown us how to turn towels into something a little bit more special.
That's correct. Well, Cameron Matheson.
She's very talented.
I like to leave no stone unturned when it comes to Christmas decorating, and the bathroom or the hand towel is no different. About a year ago, probably, I made these really cute gingerbread towels.
Right.
And they're so fun, they're so whimsical, and we got such amazing feedback. People did them in their homes and got like amazing comments from their guests, which is exactly what we want. So I thought I would do another version of it that's maybe a little bit more like elevated, depending on your style, since those were a little kitschy. And I thought this is so fun. It's got different textures. Not only do we have the plaid, but we've got rhinestones and sequins, and that really fun metallic texture makes them feel really special.
And in the holidays, of course, we do our holiday decorations, but you can rein in the little details like this.
Exactly.
The little subtleties. That's what really
Because it's just sort of tying the thread through the home so there aren't these big vacant pockets where it's got, you know, it's beautiful in one room and then it's just like, wah, wah, somewhere else.
Okay. I'd like to make these early.
Okay.
What do we need to do to make them?
All right. So you're going to need a little bit of cardstock, and that's just to create the pattern for your letters. So you need cardstock. You're going to need a different variety of options of plaid materials. It doesn't have to be flannel like we did, but you want
like
it to be
flannel.
Sort of, a Christmassy looking plaid.
Okay.
Then you want some kind of trim. This is up to you and the style that you want to end up creating.
Beautiful.
So all those trims are fully available. We're going to create this with Fabri-Tac, which is our fabric glue.
Okay.
But you could sew this. And then the last thing would be fray check, which is just to treat the edges.
Okay.
So as
you're cutting the fabric,
exactly.
So it doesn't all fray. And
exactly.
So where do we start? What's the first thing we need to do?
All right, so I want to create another version of the joy, the big joy that I did. I want to do another version that's a smaller letter. So what I'm going to do is I decided for this one that I want to use this trim again because I thought it was really fun and it sort of fits my style. So what I would recommend doing is make a little mark or measure it how big the actual trim is.
And the reason is?
Because you want to see a nice hefty border all the way around the letter. That way it looks like the trim is floating inside, bordered by the plaid.
So much easier to do it that way than to cut your letters out and try and find trim that kind of
go
fits
to the
properly.
Fabric store. Yeah, absolutely.
Right, that's the way I would
do it. Yeah, spend 3 days and
Anyway.
Okay, so then what you would do is now you kind of know that I want to make sure my letter is about that wide.
Okay.
So if you're great, if you've got an artistic hand, you can now freehand it, measure that and freehand it about that large, or you could print them on the computer. Okay?
Okay,
so once you create your letters, here you can see I've got mine. Once you create your letters, you use these as a stencil. So I'm going to take the fabric that I've decided to use and also kind of be considerate of all the different options of placement. Do you want it on this? Do you want it on just blue? You know, kind of think about where you're doing it. And now with a marker, a Sharpie, anything, you're gonna go along the outside and you can see that I've got a little border along the outside, and that's so I'm making it bigger than my letter actually is, and that's because it gives me room to cut inside of my line
so I
don't see the fabric.
You don't want to see you don't want to see the marker on the fabric.
Exactly. Exactly.
Right.
So now you would take your fabric scissors and you would just cut right on the inside of all those lines.
Okay.
And this is what we end up with. We end up with all of our letters that have been cut out. And we're going to, it's time to add on our trim.
Our glitz and glam and trim. And we're going to do that with some Fabri-Tac, right?
Yeah, exactly. And I made a big J. I thought maybe I wanted you to try one.
Great.
I thought, so I made the big J because I thought the red sequins I didn't get a chance to use. And nothing screams Cameron like red sequins.
No, I mean, like when I think of me around the holidays, I think of red sequins for
sure. Me too. That's what Vanessa said. So now I'm going to add my fabric glue. So what you want to do is just add a thin layer right down the center.
Okay.
Oops. You don't need a lot. This is pretty strong, so you don't need a ton of it. A nice
Very
layer,
good.
Why don't you do that?
Okay.
And now, this is a pretty important tip. So I'm gonna start off just, you wanna match your border. So if you gave yourself about a quarter inch on the sides, drop down your top sequin and make sure you give a quarter inch on top. Now, when you get to the bottom here, and you're gonna have that situation too, Cameron, you wanna kinda curl it. So take your trim and curl it around so that you can create and get that nice shape that you need to make your J.
Okay.
So and you guys are all gonna sort of realize you have this, not issue, but challenge when you're doing it, is like push your finger down and hold that in place so
and
that you're able now to curl it. Yeah, and like let it stay in place while it dries.
There you go.
So that's what you're gonna do now. You're just gonna cut off the excess. You could always measure it beforehand and cut a perfect size trim first if you want, but if not, look, now we have our joy written out. So when it comes to treating it, there's two things. big, major success. Whew. There's two things I'd recommend. One is you can use Fray Check, which is a great product that's just going to basically prevent any fraying on our flannel.
And it's flannel, it's a pretty amazing.
It's fantastic. So you would just drop a little layer all the way around. I've already done it, so I'm not going to do that. And now it's deciding on your placement. Keep in mind that most of the time you're folding the towels kind of like this.
Right.
And hanging them over.
So basically keep in mind how you're going to hang them and where you're going to hang them in the room.
So that you kind of figure out where to center your letters.
Exactly.
So now that I have it folded the way that I want it, I'm going to lay out the letters and make sure that I have enough room to fit them all the way that I want.
And also Fabri-Tac for that as well.
Yes. And just make sure that when you're doing this, if you can sew, by the way, this is a really awesome detail, would be to sew all the edges with like a contrasting color, like maybe a red. And it just takes a little more skill. So if that's not within your skill set, then the fabric glue is a great option. And you just want to make sure you get right along all those edges so that it sits, you know, nice and flat.
Beautiful. So we'll apply the glue.
Exactly.
And then while we're doing that, I'll ask you about keeping these clean. Obviously, when you use towels, they get a little bit dirty. But you pointed out something really, really wise to me, and that was?
Yes. What I would recommend doing, well, first, if they get dirty, I would really recommend a simple hand washing because they are delicate. But if To avoid that, I would recommend flanking either. So let's say this is your main towel. I would put two plain towels of either a complementary color or the same color next to it so that people obviously have an option and know, oh, this is decor. I'll go ahead and use this
that
plain one next
to it. That is the smartest piece of advice ever.
Yeah, I think it
because
people
really,
will know.
People will know. And if they don't know,
Now they know.
Oh, nice one. Look at that. I'm getting lost in it.
But look, I mean, it'll lay, and this is the nice
that
thing. Because you go
really
nice
tight
to the edge, look, there's no, you're not going to be able to peel that off because I put the glue so close to that edge that it really fuses it and makes it really seamless.
I mean, this is fantastic, Orly. Thank
Pretty,
you
right?
so much.
Thank
I
you.
Love that.